Your Holiness, on behalf of Bardor Rinpoche and all the KPL directors and the members, some of them have come for a very long distance across the country. We welcome you back. A lot of people worked extremely hard to get things ready, and I think you'll agree it's the shrine room's changed quite a bit. I'm also here to welcome you are some of our local physicians who have cared for us. Going from right to left, we have Dr. Gooch, Dr. DiNapoli, Dr. Holly Lobetz, Dr. Paul Lobetz. Both Dr. Lobetz, they went to Tibet last year with the medical mission for Rockwell Foundation, and they have their tickets booked. They'll be going back again this year. And then we have our legal counsel for Kunzang Palchen Ling, Michael Lonergan. As much as people really helped here, like Debbie organized all the registration, Naomi worked with the website people, Joe Wong and Anne Hu are in the down in the kitchen, many people, our carpenters, Dan Curtis, Paul Varel, Hans, J.S., worked very hard. But as hard as people have worked, we couldn't have built this place without the support and especially the trust from the town of Red Hook. So representing the town today, the mayor, Ed Blondell, is our town clerk, Cindy Cole. We have our past town supervisor, Mary Rose Blum. And we have our current supervisor here, Ms. Sue Crane. So we asked her if she could say a couple words of welcome for us.
Good morning, Your Holiness. It is so good to be with you, and thank you for coming and gracing our town of 12,000 people. We are amazed at the transformation of this beautiful building. And we welcome you. It is my great privilege and pleasure to be here, to look forward to being inspired as I was the last time you were here. Thank you for your wisdom. The world longs for wisdom. Thank you.
So, Your Holiness, we have a pretty large turnout today. Maybe there's about 200 people downstairs in the basement. So we ask, please, just as all of us here in the shrine room, we receive your blessing just from hearing your voice and seeing you here, that they may also receive that same blessing downstairs. Thank you.
다드린데 그래서 빠진 야 양결 자 고급 준비 준비다 더드리네 에네 바드룸 부지에 다나 신기 아주 이 최소기 레지 받아 아니 처음이다 다는 생 아주 산에기 에 아주 지 분리다 안 다나 신 감바 디나리에 창다 안다 감바 월이야 예바 창말라
I'm very happy to have this opportunity to return today to Kunzang Palchen Ling, and I want to thank all of you and welcome all of you of Bardor Rinpoche, the administrators of this center, all its members, the officials of the, from the town of Red Hook, and everyone who is in this room, as well as everyone who is underneath this room. Originally, the schedule or program was that I would present the empowerment of the Medicine Buddha here today. But lately I've been feeling a little unwell and also I've been unable to rest. So my immune system is running so low that it would be simply too much for me to give this empowerment first here and then this afternoon again at Kajitutum Chuling.
之前大地
It's possible that because I've been talking so much over this tour that the Dakinis and Dharmapalas are displeased and have sent this illness to tell me to not talk too much. However, as there are so many of you here today, I will present the reading transmission for the Medicine Buddha practice and the transmission of its mantra.
Duba samar veta ji namgyu yongzha ki melay ki sungar di long cha yin.
There are several versions of the Medicine Buddha Dharani. The transmission I'll be giving today will be of the most commonly used one, which is also one of the shorter ones.
Dang yin liya melay ki sung di long cha.
So I think it would be best if first I give you the transmission for the Dharani mantra of the Medicine Buddha, and after that say a few words in connection with it. Please repeat after me.
Tadyata.
Tadyata.
Om.
Om.
Bekanze.
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 Maha.
Maha.
Bekanze.
Bekanze.
Raja.
Raja.
Samugate.
Samugate.
Swaha.
Swaha.
Tadyata.
Tadyata.
Om.
Om.
Bekanze.
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 Maha.
Maha.
Bekanze.
Bekanze.
Raja.
Raja.
Samugate.
Samugate.
Swaha.
Swaha.
Tadyata.
Tadyata.
Om.
Om.
Bekanze.
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 Maha.
Maha.
Bekanze.
Bekanze.
Raja.
Raja.
Samungati.
Samungate.
Swaha.
Swaha.
Ada tegi ye kashurji melek sangi melek da sungarbdi yongrarbdi tishgare chesa ane daji kashure di ta tinen da melek sunga nyamle na nyen nam gyin pena ji suzu mengi pena melek sunga kharjo melan nyamle na nge ane sunga dangge Tentu ia begini na, ini dia kerja, tadi ini dia ngaji, ne, longgi cundu kita tadi si pribis.
So that is the best known and most commonly used dharani of the Medicine Buddha. So if any of you recite it or do the Medicine Buddha practice, then today I've given you the necessary mantra transmission.
That's Kajure Lamsa, Tadis Missa Chemia Vinza, Mabuji should have get home and do. Ta imbinea, Ta Kesi should GD. Tene Mimabuji assembled Alora. The Sange main leg is Sunga Dembina. Si Sosu Nepan Jin Ne Nazar Yavina, Tedelia Pento Yavda.
I haven't prepared any particular lecture on the subject of the Medicine Buddha, so I'm not going to say too much. But the most important thing is that many people think that if they recite the Medicine Buddha Dharani, it will help them heal their own illnesses. And if they are healers or medical practitioners, it will give them a greater ability to heal others.
You know, Sange Mielati Mimabuji Samlu Nalolia. That doctor and the doctor is there. Taina Sanki Melaki doctor is somewhere with Daji. Tadi Kina Namu, tell me, maybe Gabor is loud. That did she got it? That dangerous on a Sanki Melati, Unetanaji. Never major Sinki, member Dobachi. Takantan Hans, Father Julia. Did you see that?
Many people think of the Medicine Buddha as a kind of doctor or physician, and after all, we do refer to him as the king of physicians. But really, we need to understand the point behind why we call this Buddha the Medicine Buddha and what that actually signifies.
The
The root texts that form the basis for all Tibetan medicine are the four medicinal tantras. And the origin of these is disputed. Some say they were taught by the Buddha. Others say they were composed as shastras by Indian scholars. And still others say that they were written by Tibetans. Some attempt to use clever casuistry to resolve this disparity or dispute by saying that outwardly they were written by Tibetans, inwardly by Indian scholars, and secretly were the teachings of the Buddha, which is merely casuistry, as I said. However, in these tantras, the causes of illness are identified as the proximate cause and the fundamental cause. The fundamental cause of illness is the three poisons, attachment, aversion, and delusion. The reason we call the medicine Buddha or Bhaisajya Guru, the teacher of medicine, by this name is that while physical illnesses can be treated and cured by worldly physicians, the fundamental or distant cause of illness, the three poisons of attachment, aversion, and delusion, cannot be cured by worldly physicians and need some kind of special or even supreme medicine. In the Buddhist tradition, a very common analogy employed to describe our relationship to the three jewels is that the Buddha is like a physician, the Dharma like the medicine dispensed by that physician, and the Sangha like our nurses. The reason we employ this analogy is that the three poisons are what we could call the root or fundamental illness and the source of all other illness.
Today, just another day, physical ne thamje chue ro res che che khandar chue di ti kar re kar ne che tu ba ro chi tin de che res la gu wa ma re ni na zu di nga zu gi ta physical ne de zu chuo chi ne da physical ne mang bu jile ta chue ta yo ra ka sel chue ta yo ma re te khandar ya khandar ka shme Kandar nei ba ngo she tu yan ji yong di yare yine ya na sim gi nyomo ba di zo nei ba da ma ma bu ji gi ngo shin gi ma da de ne ji ba ngo sin gi ma re and ne du san di jun zen de ne en na ba sang gi be che jo to ne an rang gi ji nyomo tu sum ru di nei ba ji le ba ngo ru chi
It's never said that Dharma practice can cure all physical illnesses, or for that matter, that the practice of Dharma can solve all of one's problems. But while many physical illnesses can be cured and some others cannot, we at least recognize physical sickness as such. However, we usually fail to recognize our fundamental mental sickness the three poisons of affliction, of aversion, attachment, and delusion as sicknesses. So one function of the Buddha's teachings is to point out that these are a form of illness.
Suzuki Ranshin of the Shindajilia. Your name that's a mission that of Chandu over the Tinjang Sona, simply give you are it. Dantology other dream you stand Kandar Namjung Azuki Shedan the Melpesha are it. Shedan the Kisi Shedan the Quran physical Nuban of Javina. Men and sing it some of us just sound ruin of the That is in a ton of the nation on the yard. Says that the Junzel then the dig that in your motto someday name on water in it and tell it at Yambo Dene. New motto someday name silver charity. Yes, somebody at that sank him like Yamin Sivakalia. G Nangas and Andran to Tana sing it focuses.
For example, most of us have the experience of becoming angry. And we've all experienced how when we become angry, we become a different person with a different personality. To use a physical analogy, our anger is like a fire that can burn everything around it. I think, therefore, that the main point and the main focus of the Medicine Buddha practice is that once one has recognized these three mental afflictions, these three poisons, as illness, to employ their appropriate remedies. And I think the Medicine Buddha practice serves as a remedy for those.
Tana singi nyomo tusum di ne rabji imbe jira yana dön rabji imbe ta tende je ngunzi chebe jelya kansa shin simje shenle ya en tende be ta ji nyomo tusum gi ne chimbu ye ro sana ta do pene ju kontro sabro chagdo chimbro de ye bi ne ya na ju ji understand che tu ji da quran jangwa me ba Taji Yomoto Sungi Negi Simbi Indusane, Taji Yonasin Richache. The Nirvijibi Indusane, as which you understand it, Richetuji down, and the Anasin Kichi Kare Sieneajin Zewe Samba. Tell a den in Zewe Samba get to Arabici. The Niji, your silver something you. The Indusane, that digs up Arudi, turn in to Arabici. The Niamisha Telden Susugi. thusum ngodeng chik thusum de ngor chhab chi da kansa sing yuli yebe ji nyomo ba tsu yin bi na nyomo ba ya kasu ngue sine tele yin bi na ji su su sam lo dang dang de xie ba de xiong ge sam cheng ye.
In addition to that, our mental afflictions, our three poisons, are not only like sicknesses, they're also like demons. And if we understand our own three poisons and how they affect and afflict us, then when we see others who are heavily sick with the three poisons, making them very angry or very jealous, we will understand how it is they have become that way, that they have no control over their three poisons, and that it has made them, as it were, a little insane. So another benefit of this practice is it will make it easier for us to have understanding and therefore to be more loving toward others who are afflicted. I think, therefore, that the Medicine Buddha practice serves two purposes. It helps us recognize our own sickness of mental afflictions and apply the appropriate remedies, but it also helps us recognize these things in others and have more love and empathy toward them. I'm not going to say too much more about the Medicine Buddha, because after all, I am a little ill at the moment. And given that we usually think that the Medicine Buddha magically cures all illness, we would expect a practitioner of the Medicine Buddha who's qualified to teach it to not, at least not be sick while they're teaching it. I've now talked quite a bit, which is kind of like giving an empowerment, except that an empowerment would involve us doing lots of visualizations and other things that are much more difficult than simply sitting here talking and listening. So this is much easier. In any case, I'm delighted to have had this opportunity to return today to Kunzang Palchen Ling. I'm especially pleased to see that Bardor Rinpoche's health has improved and that his family is doing very well. And I also very much appreciate and am grateful to all of you who have come here today for taking the time to do so. Then
chaza ngarai ne thari de thin sumba din de ja so chung yin min ju sa ne ta gyang ju ju be ji shab je sim bar ji tene ru chung so sa bar ji tene cheng do a la bar do an thari de america yang de ta ta wa ni ji ru tene ji gi ko ga bar tene ji ja be yin bin zang tele den che ane sa ji mang bu chen ro tu ba ta mi mang bu chi tu tu bar tene chung bre.
This is my third visit to the United States. I think that my predecessor, the 16th Karmapa, was one of the first major Tibetan lamas to travel internationally in the 1970s. And in particular, he came to the United States three times. As this is now my third visit, I feel that I'm successfully following in his footsteps. Because this time I have been able to spend 2 months in this country, I've been able to go all over and meet with many different people.
That
Now, while when I first envisaged this tour, 2 months sounded like a long time, and I imagined that I would be able to work some of the time and rest some of the time, it hasn't turned out that way. This 2 month tour has become very tightly packed with all sorts of scheduled activities. And while I continue to complete the tour, my physical energy is now exhausted. It's insufficient for this tour. Well, now I know. Before coming to America, while I'm still in India, I will have to engage in rigorous physical conditioning so that I be able to, so that I be in good enough shape to handle America.
American media, technology, chambo, toshu chendo kawa. Energy nuba chendo kawa tongto, America size. Jalazam, America size, chimbo yangadua. Tinin visana, Jirazo Nashinga, Penny, Suyon, the Michung Junji, the Nuba Chambo Mindo. Pova de Chungjunji. Then Dana Shingi, Pizza is a Chungjung, Hamburger Chungjung, Yanam Jin Lage, Pizza Kishila, Chambo Chikanda. Martin de Gomez, the Chulun size Kishos, the Boozag.
American people, by and large, are big and strong and very energetic. In particular, everything is big in this country. American-sized portions, American-sized cups, everything is gigantic. I'm just a little Tibetan. I can't really handle that. I drink out of small cups. And if I eat a pizza, I want a small pizza. When I ask somebody to bring me a pizza, they bring me this huge thing that I can't possibly handle on my own. You know,
I want all the children size.
I want.
Oh, that name is an. And that machine is sunny. She got on the other day.
Well, tomorrow I'm going to Chicago, which no doubt will be even more tiring, and I don't know.
No. I'm not so sure.
You're not so sure.
Okay. Still.
But I want to thank all of you here and all of you beneath here. And I'm probably going to go down and visit the folks who are buried under the ground here.